Uncle William Cooper, born in 1861, was already in his 70s as he fought the injustices Indigenous people were facing. But when he came across persecution others were facing, he fought that as well.
Connection between the Indigenous people of Australia and the Jewish people.
When news of Kristallnacht reached Australian shores, one man decided it was time to take action. William Cooper led a delegation that marched from his Footscray home to the gates of the German embassy in South Melbourne. They were denied entry, but the protest was made whilst the rest of the world fell silent.
Hi, and welcome to the first episode of season 24 of The Shtick. This week we're going to the Western Suburbs Indigenous Gathering Place, where Warren Wills set up an international Skype connection with the great celebrity Pamela Anderson, who also has an interest in human rights and animal welfare. With us we'll have Kevin Russell, the great grandson of William Cooper, and A.B. Schwartz, who both went to Israel this year. It's going to be a very interesting journey. Follow us along the way. It's autumn, end of summer, and we hope you rug up and enjoy the shtick.
Invite Warren Wills, who is our MC for the day, and I just want to say, everybody, give him a big clap, because I really think that a man of his calibre coming here and taking an interest in our youth and internationally, I thank you very much. Please give him a big welcome.
A huge thank you to Colleen, first of all, and a huge thank you to all of you for coming today. And we're here for one reason, and that is kids, that is youth. And kids and youth who don't particularly get the opportunities that perhaps they need, kids who perhaps come from disadvantaged backgrounds, kids who have special needs, kids who are demonised by the press, kids who are simply looking to be recognised, accepted and be part of a group and part of a team. And the work that I'm involved with over the past 8 years in London, for want of a better word, we call SHED, which is actually a nice way, a kid-friendly way we like to think, of talking about socially inclusive music theatre. And for those who don't know the work that we do, basically work together with about 70 children or youth, and we work together with a team of probably about 30 practitioners, volunteers, and we create world premieres of West End style, brand new pieces of new musicals. We do this over a intensive two-week period, where, again, our participants, our company, which is both, again, the practitioners and the kids, are involved in every aspect of the production. That is the devising of it, the collaboration in terms of the script and the score, as well as the staging, the blocking of it, the dancing, the choreography, etc. And in terms of actually putting this on a stage, what we aim to do is, rather than sort of box something together and put it on, we'll bring in the best people we can in terms of lighting and sound, costumes, design. So it really is a proper West End experience. But in addition to that, what tends to happen in the 2 weeks is for the kids who are involved. And as I say, we've done this with a number of kids who have autism, cerebral palsy, spina bifida, and so on. And kids who are referred to us from either traumatised or criminal backgrounds. The aim also is that the kids turn up expecting to be getting involved with singing, with dancing, with stagecraft, with acting and so on, but it's all the other aspects which are about self-esteem, working to deadlines, playing as a team, and a whole thing of actually taking ownership of something which is creative, work of music. And unlike sport, we are in a win-win situation. It's not an adversarial process. We're all here working harmoniously together, simply to work, putting on a premiere of a piece of music theatre as best as we can. Along the journey from London, I spoke to my friend Beth Rankin, who's sitting over here, who's representing Latrobe University today, who became very actively involved and facilitated our first trip over here. And I brought another practitioner, a fantastic drama practitioner with me, named Yaman. And we worked together for 2 weeks, and then a new idea formed off the back of getting very involved and very inspired and excited by the name William Cooper. And I've got to put my hand up and say that when I first landed in Shepparton, I, as an Australian, am ashamed to say I had no knowledge of who William Cooper was. And thanks to a number of serendipitous situations, partly through to Abe here, and also through some research that Yaman, my practitioner, did, not only did we get to know William Cooper, we also got to know his grandson, Uncle Boydie, and I'm thrilled to say his great-grandson, Kevin, is here. And so much of the work that William Cooper did many, many years ago is what we're attempting to do, I suppose, but in a musical theatre context, and that is building bridges, offering hope, and really allowing people's talents to come to the fore. And I say this from a background as well, working as a musical director a lot in the West End and a composer, it's not simply that you work with the best people. Often, you know, names come forward, and it's my job to make people who've never sung, danced, or whatever on stage and make them look good. My feeling about it is everyone has talents, everyone has skills, and we can make everyone look good. It's not that difficult, as long as we can create an environment that's conducive to allow people to want to share their skills. So the whole William Cooper experience in Shepparton was fantastic. Off the back of that, my good friend Les Twentyman here, who is a hero of mine and a champion of all the right reasons, and Colleen, who I've just met today, opened up the idea of getting involved with the Western suburbs. And again, my feeling is wherever there's a challenge, wherever there's a situation where we can make a contribution to the challenges and issues that affect youth and kids, we're happy to do so. So an idea was put forward about the Western suburbs, and particularly given the plight of Indigenous Australians, and it was put to me, is it possible to set up, to implement a program, a three-year program that would look at nine venues? And the nine venues, if I get this right, we've already established a fantastic link with the Chinese and Australian government in Hong Kong. And I go from here to Hong Kong to be doing the work there. Partly due to Pamela's involvement, we're also looking at LA and New York as part of the three-year program. And in Australia, we're looking obviously at Shepparton, and adding to that with the western suburbs, with Darebin, which is another catchment area of Latrobe, Mildura, and Tasmania.